Konnichiwa. Today, we're going to talk about a new development in learning Japanese with anime. And it's quite an important one. It opens up quite a lot of possibilities for us. And then I'm going to answer a rather important question on this whole topic of learning Japanese through anime. So, as we know already, you can learn Japanese through anime if you go about it the right way. And the first important thing is that you need to use Japanese anime with Japanese subtitles. When I first started using this approach, there weren't any Japanese subtitled Japanese anime streaming services, so there was only one way to do it, and that was to get hold of the anime, get hold of the subtitles in a different file, and when you put them both into your media player, 9 times out of 10, they would be out of sync. So you would have to re-time them in a separate subtitle editor. And usually you didn't have to re-time them once, you had to re-time them 3 times. They'd be out of sync at the beginning for the cold start. Then after the opening music, they'd be out of sync again. And then after the half-time break, they'd be out of sync yet again. So each time you'd have to go into your subtitle editor, calculate the timings, edit the subtitles, save them, and put them back into your media player again. And if you wanted to look up a word that you didn't understand, and if you didn't know the kanji, and in the early days that happens pretty often, the only thing you could do would be to go back into your subtitle editor again and search some text near the place where your unknown kanji appeared, copy the kanji, go into your browser, and paste it into a dictionary or something, and go from there. So it's a very cumbersome and time-consuming process, and that's why I've only been recommending streaming Japanese subtitled anime sites up to this point. However, there are some drawbacks of streaming sites. They can be a bit flaky, they can throw advertisements at you, they don't always work, but more importantly, your choice of anime is quite limited. They have quite a lot, but there are subtitles available for far more anime than you find on the streaming sites, so you may not be able to get what you really want to watch, especially if your interests don't lie in the shonen, seinen area. So what it is that I've discovered is a free media player called Potplayer. It was recommended to me because it allows you to run 2 sets of subtitles at the same time. You can have your Japanese subtitles on the bottom and your English subtitles on the top. Now, as you probably know, I don't recommend this at all. But seeing how clever it was at handling subtitles, I took a look to see what else it could do, and it turns out that it can do some very interesting and indeed game-changing things. The most important of these is that you can edit your subtitles right inside the player, and you can do it much more easily than you would do it with a dedicated subtitle editor. The way you do this is you get your subtitles, you get your anime. Nearly always the subtitles are ahead of the anime. That's to say that the characters will start speaking and there will be no subtitles for some time, and then they'll come in all out of sync. So all you have to do with Potplayer is play the anime, wait till the first character opens her mouth, and then you press Control plus Alt and the greater than key. That's to say the right pointing angle bracket. And what happens then is that it fetches the first subtitle to the point you're at, where you want it, and all the other subtitles along with it. So you're then synced until it becomes unsynced again. When it does that, you can simply repeat the same process and it'll bring up the rest of the subtitles to where you are now. It won't affect the ones that you've gone past. So you can do this 3 times or as many times as you like in order to keep your anime in sync throughout. And then you can save the subtitles, so you don't have to do this job again, and it's only a very small job compared with what you used to have to do. This opens up a whole new field. Now, when you encounter a word you don't know, In the old style, media player, those words were completely inaccessible inside the subtitles. But in Pod Player, what you can do is right-click or two-finger-click the word that you want to look up, and you'll get this menu. And it doesn't look like this when you first get Pod Player, but as you can see, it allows you to search the web for what's in your subtitle, and you can search Wikipedia or whatever you want to. And what I've done here is that I've added San Siro and Jisho to that list. And it's very easy to do. All you have to do is right-click the subtitle, and then you select from the menu Customize, and you click Add, and then you just put in the name of the search engine you want, and the search string. Now the search string is a little bit more obscure. For Jisho, it's very easy. It's just jisho.org/search/%%SS. For San Siro, it's a little bit more complicated, and I'll put the search strings in the comments below. So what you do once you've got that set up is when you see something you want to look up in the subtitles, all you have to do is click it, just single click it, and it will open up your selected dictionary, Jisho or San Siro or whatever you want, and the text will be sitting there in the search box of your search engine. Now it's not quite perfect because it doesn't isolate a single word for you, so you'll probably have a little bit more text. It tends to break it up into fairly small chunks, but you'll probably have a little more text than you actually want. But all you have to do is delete the unwanted text and hit return, and you've got the dictionary definition. Or if you're using Yomi-chan, you don't even have to do that. You just hover Yomi-chan over it and go ahead in the normal manner. This opens up a whole new world of possible anime, because you can go to a place called Kitsuneko, which has a lot of Japanese anime subtitles, and I'll put the link for that in the information section below as well. And if you're a dorama fan, there are sites with a lot of dorama subtitles, which is excellent because the streaming sites really don't cater to dorama to a huge extent. They have a bit, but with this, you can have a much, much wider choice. Now, the question that I was asked, which I'm going to tackle, is that somebody said to me, is it all right to be watching Japanese anime with Japanese subtitles? The Ajat people say that watching with subtitles, even Japanese subtitles, is cheating because you're not listening, you're reading. And the answer to this, a little while ago, I did a video on contrasting the organic method with the Ajat style methods. And some people asked me why I did this. And this is one of the reasons why. Because I wanted to explain that they are in fact two very different ecologies. I'm not saying that one's right and the other one's wrong. But I'm saying that a lot of things they do for a reason. You have to cover all the bases in order to learn Japanese, like kanji and vocabulary and structure. And the two ecologies do this in rather different ways. So with Ajat, you learn structure and you learn words and how they fit together from 10,000 Anki sentences. Now, with the organic method, we don't do that. We learn structure as structure from my structure lessons, and the rest of Japanese, the vocabulary, the kanji, the getting used to how everything fits together, we do all of this through real Japanese immersion, through anime, and whatever other media we want to use. So we don't have these isolated sentences that we review in Anki. And what we're doing instead is we're using subtitled anime. Now, some people are going to say, is this going to help you to actually hear Japanese? And my answer to that is only halfway. Because we're using anime as our main university of Japanese, unlike the thousand sentences method, we're not encountering words as written entities. We're encountering them as written and spoken entities at the same time. The word and its pronunciation are linked from the beginning. This is good for our listening. It's good for our appreciation of words and language. But it's perfectly true that this on its own is not going to get you to be able to hear spoken Japanese easily unless you've got a particularly good ear. So perhaps to some people's surprise, I do in fact recommend watching Japanese anime without subtitles. But I don't recommend doing it from an early stage the way Ajat does. I recommend doing this at a later stage once you've got a firm base in structure and you've got a reasonable amount of vocabulary. You should start watching some anime without subtitles. You shouldn't make some drastic changeover and say, I'm not going to use subtitles anymore. What you'll be doing is watching some with and some without. Probably the best approach in most cases is to watch simpler anime that you can grasp more easily without subtitles. You still won't be getting it all because it takes time to learn to listen. But you watch a simpler anime without subtitles and your more complex anime with subtitles because you're still using this to learn words, to learn structures, to get used to Japanese. I'll probably be making an entire video on this non-subtitled anime part of the process, which I call Learning Japanese Through Anime Phase 2. If you have any other questions or if you want to pursue this question further, please do so in the comments below, and I will answer as usual. I'd like to thank my Gold Kokeshi patrons and all my patrons and supporters on Patreon and everywhere. You'll find my Red Kokeshi in the information section below, along with those vital links. And I'd like to thank you for attending this lesson. これからもよろしくお願いします。Class dismissed.